just got to LAX. We're about to meet up with Craig and Carly, who are our other friends that are flying first class with us to London. But first, we're gonna try to find the lounge. We gotta get some food. We got Carly, we got Craig, my seat. I'm still wearing jeans and a t-shirt, and they actually just gave us pajamas to change into. This is freaking awesome. Just switched into the pajamas, so this is the first class fit. They just laid me down. They just made my bed. This is my little cubby. I'm gonna go to bed, get some shut-eye, and then we'll wake up in London. What was your opinion? First class experience.
I thought it was great. I had a good sleepies. And I got some pancakes.
But we made it off the flight, and now we are at the tube, as they say. We're gonna be taking a train from Heathrow Airport over to London. The funny thing is all of us with our phones out and filming, like, this is the first time we're seeing it. We're so obviously tourists, but I do not care. I'm having so much fun that I don't care what anybody thinks.
I feel like I'm still in the Bay Area.
That bus says otherwise. All right, first look at the hotel room. Let's put this in. That's a little TV. Ooh, we can see the London Eye out there on the distance.
Start with expensive. We're in Europe, man. Come on.
In Spain, choose Spain potatoes and fire.
Hey, to you, happy birthday. Happy birthday to you.
Finally had some time to settle in. It is now, what is it, Thursday morning around 8:46, so it's about midnight back home. We got in yesterday and absolutely pooped out. We got in and it's about an 8-hour difference, so we thought that landing at 5 o'clock was going to mean that we were going to be awake all night, but that was not the case. We were all freaking exhausted. And I wanna talk about my experience with first class real quick, because I personally thought the first class was a little bit overrated. I was, not to say disappointed, because, you know, we obviously used travel points to book this trip, so we didn't actually pay any money for the flights. However, if I didn't use travel points, those tickets round trip for both me and Megan would have been around $8,000. And I just don't think on principle that it was worth $8,000. It was pretty much a 9-hour ride with a cheap bottle of champagne. Sure, you can get as much food and drinks as you want, but I'm a bodybuilder. I'm not, you know, I'm tracking my macros. I'm not having, you know, endless rounds of food on the flight. I pretty much slept the entire time. The bed was not very comfortable at all. I'll show you a couple clips of me sleeping. And I just woke up in a lot of pain. And, you know, I slept the whole time. And I thought that would have been a waste of $7,000 if I had spent that on my own money. Now, a lot of people say that the Virgin first class isn't as good as others. They say that Polaris United is the best first class. And I've never tried it, so I can't really speak on that. But from my experience so far with first class, I personally would have rather have saved thousands and thousands of dollars, sit in economy seat, and suck it up for 9 hours. Like, for me, I want to respect my money a little bit more than to blow it on, you know, a shitty couch to sleep on that actually ended up hurting me. You know, I think I probably could have got those round trip tickets for $500 if I had gone economy versus $7,000. And hey, we're all going to the same place and it's still going to take as long as anyone else, first class or economy, and we're still going to have the same back pain. So at the end of the day, you know, I just feel like you know, it's a little bit pretentious. People who are always talking about first class, it just wasn't for me. You know, will I do it again? If I have the points to book it through, you know, absolutely. Well, shit, maybe not even. Maybe I'll save the points and, you know, go on more trips frequently rather than using first class to, you know, spend all of my points. So I don't know. We'll see. But we got in last night. We went to dinner. After dinner, I was shot. We came back here, slept, and I think I'm sick. Like, I do not feel well. I don't know if it's, you know, had to do with the wedding and then me blacking out the wedding and then having, you know, 2 days back to back where we're exerting ourselves physically while I'm still hungover, breaking down the wedding venue and then traveling and then having 9 hours where I'm not sleeping or I'm sleeping on a plane and not getting good sleep. So yeah, I woke up today, I'm like, I don't feel good at all, but we are going to power through. I think we're going to go down and do some sightseeing today and do some shopping tomorrow. So take it with us.
Wait, this isn't cappuccino, this is a latte, this one. A latte's good. I thought you meant this cappuccino.
I like that cappuccino.
Did you really? I got oatmeal.
I don't do oatmeal.
They just had a triple decker cheeseburger.
You guys are so.
I totally forgot to enter in a vlog yesterday, but we are walking through London today. We're gonna go shopping and I'll give you a little recap of what happened yesterday. So woke up extremely tired, extremely like kind of sick. And I kind of had that the entire day, but we pushed through. Yesterday we started with going to breakfast. We walked around town a little bit. We got tickets to go see the Buckingham Palace. And then we walked to Zara while we waited for our tour of the Buckingham Palace to start. After Zara, we walked over to the Buckingham Palace, took our tour. I will tell you, it was really cool, but they didn't allow any flash photography or any photography whatsoever. As soon as you pulled your phone out, someone would be right there to tell you to put the phone away. After the Buckingham Palace, we were all pretty tired, so we went back to the hotel to get some sleep and get, you know, just some rest. And then we went out for dinner at a burger spot, which was fantastic. And then we went out to the bar. The bar life was really, really cool. Very, you know, classic European pubs. And you don't get that often in the US because, you know, you get a lot of clubs and bars, but not so much pubs. And so that was a really cool experience. So far, I really like London. I think it's a really underrated city. I think the layout is really interesting because it's not like a grid, like in New York City. Everything is kind of a maze. All the streets kind of twist and turn, and you don't know what you're gonna get around any corner. You know, there could be, you know, a monument or a statue or, you know, something historical, which is really cool. And then I also love the fact that there are a ton of old, really old buildings mixed in with new buildings at the same time. It just makes it for a very, very fun, interesting city. Like, look at this. Like, this is really cool. Opinion on London is that I like it. I definitely would be back. I would prefer it over New York City, in my opinion, because it's got a city feel, but it's not as overwhelming as New York City. So today what we're gonna do is we're gonna go shopping. Megan's gonna try to find some clothes to buy here. I'm gonna try to find some, you know, maybe get a gift for Megan for a honeymoon. And then we're gonna go to Borough Markets later this evening. And then we leave for Paris tomorrow. So I'll keep you guys updated. Just made it to Dover Street Market, which is kind of like this hodgepodge store. So they just busted me for no filming in here. So I'll try to get a couple of videos. We are here at the Gymshark store, which is pretty cool. Oh, my eyes are super fucked up. This means a lot because Gymshark was the first brand that I fell in love with that got me into fitness. You know, my very first dream was to be a Gymshark athlete, and to come to their flagship store here in London is pretty freaking awesome. The street's beautiful, and let's go take a look inside.
Second favorite wine in France.
I'm pretty easy to please.
You guys don't have any
Shepherd Rothschild here, huh? It's a good way to start the lunch. You're right, babe? Probably not the smartest idea we've had of the day, but we are currently on Lime Bicycles. We are leaving Dover Street where we went shopping. We had a really cool experience at the Gymshark. I got a new sweatshirt and joggers. Megan got something. And we have to cross the river over to the next kind of area. We're gonna go to the graffiti tunnels. So now we're riding our bikes to get there. So hopefully we don't crash. I know, I was gonna say this is a terrible idea.
One and done. The boys are okay, the girls,
Hey, I've done a pretty good job, I would say.
You have, yeah. Except you've almost hit a bus, or a bus has almost hit you twice.
Almost hit me, but I navigated around that bus quite well with very little
I couldn't
fear.
Believe how close that bus got to hitting you.
Oh yeah.
We are at the last morning in London. We're at the Borough Market because this is a place Megan really wanted to go. But after we're here, probably going to grab some coffee, morning treat. This food looks insane. Like, this food looks actually insane. I'm going to grab some Colombian coffee right this second. And then we're going to be hopping on a train to Paris. So we'll end the vlog here. I'll show you some of the food that we're looking at because this is crazy. And then we'll go ahead and roll right into the Paris vlog. What did we get?
Chocolate strawberries.
Yeah.